Hi, good evening. Welcome once again to your channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. I'm your host, Dr. Ghosh, and I'm here back today with another awe-inspiring story for all of you. For those of you who are already my subscribers on YouTube and the members of my group, Generous, Gracious and Gallant on Facebook and WhatsApp, a heartfelt thank you. For those of you who are visiting the first time on our channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant, let me give you a brief history. Generous, Gracious and Gallant was formed in 2015 on Facebook with the twin objectives of sharing the best stories of mankind. I mean, mankind at its very best, and to share daily inspiration. Today on Facebook, we have got about 790 members. On WhatsApp, we have got about 120 members. And on YouTube, which we started in May 2020 during the lockdown, COVID-19 lockdown, to share daily inspiration with you and keep you going during this tough time, we have got 117 subscribers today. In a short span of about 3 to 4 months, we have collected about 117 subscribers on the channel. Please feel free to share these stories with your friends, family and children. They are totally awe-inspiring. And if you enjoy the stories which I share with you about these awe-inspiring individuals, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you get a notification on every video which we release for you. Coming back to our story, the person, the awe-inspiring, inspirational person we are speaking about today is Mary Fields. Now, who is Mary Fields? She was the first black woman to be a mail carrier in US history. She was nicknamed Stagecoach Mary. Mary Fields was born in slavery and she was a 6-footer, 250-pound woman. Who had learned shooting, always carried a pistol and rifle on her person at all times, could outdrink the best of men in drinking whiskey, smoked cigars, and was a generous, hard-working, loyal, and intelligent woman. Once freed from slavery, she went to work on building a church. Construction workers in those days had to carry heavy loads. So, she chose to wear men's clothing and lift the heavy loads of stones and other construction material on her back. She outrightly refused the support of any men who came to offer her support on lifting these loads. She was an independent and tough lady. So much so that she could outdrink all her male construction workers. She smoked cigars and carried a rifle and pistol on her body at all times. And she could outshoot her other male construction workers. A really tough nut at 6 feet and 250 pounds. Now, while she was a tough nut, she was also known to be very generous towards children and frequently helped children on any requirements they had. As she competed with the men and wear men's clothing and also smoked and drank, this did not go down well with the church authorities and she was sacked from her work. This did not go down well with Mary, and she chose to move away and settle in Montana at Cascade Town. The sacking proved to be a blessing for her, and though she was the first and only black resident of the Cascade Town in Montana, she was offered an opportunity to work as a mailman or a mail carrier. In those days, mail carriers had to be very vigilant so as not to get robbed, as they frequently had to go into hostile territories held by the Indians in USA. Mary, despite being a woman, used to hitch her own horses, load up hundreds of pounds of mail or letters into her own stagecoach and enter hostile territory and deliver them. As already shared with you earlier, she always had her pistol and rifle on her, always. And she was a tough nut at 6 feet and 250 pounds. Frequently, in those days, due to weather condition, rains, snow, storms, roads would be unusable, and in those circumstances, Mary was very diligent and hardworking, and she would lift these packs of mails, put it on her back, and trudge through forest, snow, and unusable roads and deliver these mails in the most hostile circumstances and environments. Mary continued to deliver mail into her late 70s, and when she expired at the age of 80 as the first and only black resident of the town of Cascade, her funeral was the biggest funeral witnessed in the town. This was because she was known for her generosity and kindness towards children and other folks who required help. Yes, she was tough. She was a six-footer. She was 250 pounds. She knew how to shoot. She could outshoot the men, outdrink the men, outsmoke the men, and outshoot the men. But her heart was of gold, and her generosity was known across Montana state, wherever she delivered mail. She was known for her kindness, especially towards children. She inspired the coming generation of women, and she serves as an icon of women who refuse to be straddled down by society's dogmatic views and roles for women. She was the first black woman to be delivering mail in the history of USA. Mary Fields, also known as Stagecoach Mary, born in 1832, expired at the age of 80, and her funeral was the biggest funeral in the town of Cascade. A totally awe-inspiring lady, a tough nut, a lady who refused to be tied down by dogmatic views of society for women. A woman who learned shooting, a hard-working, generous, loyal, intelligent woman who set woman empowerment much before the word was coined. A totally awe-inspiring woman. Friends, we are undergoing COVID-19, the battle against COVID-19. mankind has seen huge losses of life, employment, and mass immigration. It is time that we stood up and be counted. Not all of us can make a difference to multiple people in society, but all of us can stand up, be counted, and make a difference to one. COVID-19 times requires that we unite as mankind, as human beings, in these difficult circumstances of our battle against COVID-19. And all of us who are capable, stand up, be counted, make a difference to one. Choose someone in your community who requires help and help them. You don't know how far the ripples of your kindness will go. Mankind requires you to be counted in the battle against COVID-19. I request you, please stand up, be counted. May I also request all of you who are new to the channel to please subscribe to the channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant, so that you will get a notification of every awe-inspiring video which I release for you. And feel free to share this among your friends, families and children, because all this content is child friendly. So friends, till we meet again with another awe-inspiring story, stay safe, wear a mask whenever you're going out in public, maintain social distancing for your own safety and for the safety of others, avoid crowded places, and most important, stand up, make a difference to one, mankind in its battle against the COVID-19 virus needs you to be a soldier against the COVID-19 virus. Till we meet again with another awe-inspiring story, good luck. All the best. Thank you. Take care.